Hi there, I'm Martin Grumet. It's May 30th, 2013, here in beautiful Boise, Idaho. I'm doing a test of my new Olympus TG-2. This is my first time taking it underwater. The video resolution is 1920 by 1080. I have it set to aperture priority, f2.8. Just at its wide angle, it's ISO 100. So I'm out by the swimming pool and I'm going to test that in the water. In the background, somebody's mowing the lawn, so there'll probably be background noise, whether it sounds like a lawnmower or whether it sounds different, I don't know. Okay, so here I am. Into the water I go. Just been in the water, but I'm just out of the water now. Olympus says it's supposed to not have water drops cling to the lens, and I see a big water drop clinging to the lens. Okay, so now that water drop seems to be cleared. Okay, so here I am next to the ladder, which I can use to now help me. It makes it a little bit easier to pull myself down into the water. It's a sunny day mostly with partly cloudy, so the sun's kind of shining through clouds. Okay, here we go again. Okay, so again, Panasonic makes this big talk about clearing the water drop. I mean, Olympus makes this big talk, clears the water drops. But okay, now but this had a couple of water drops clinging to it. Then there was, if I cleaned the lens a little bit better, whether that would have stopped that from happening. So as some of you may know, last year I was doing this test with my Panasonic TS3, and we'll see how it's compared. One issue the TS3 seemed to have was a lot of hunting on the autofocus. This one may do better in that the face detect seems to work in video. Okay, so that's my swimming pool test of the Olympus TG-2. Okay. Now, the button on this is located in the back.